Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Tell four people around you, no more bondage. It's a prophecy. It's a prophecy.
Babu Bautakuma. Babu Wene Dawdi.
No more bondage.
Babu Wene Dawka Bauta.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hebrew chapter 11.
Karanta Irbiranawa Ibrenewa Sura Shadaya.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Verse 6.
Ayashida.
Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is. And that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him.
Listen very well. He said, for without faith. I think we need another word for that. There's difference between belief and faith. Bangeskia, she ne believe.
Bangeskia,
she ne believe.
That bangeskia is what you call belief.
So, you know, because if you interpret it as bangeskia,
yes,
you will not get the proper meaning of what Apostle Paul is bringing out. So bangeskia, she ne faith go. Listen,
Musorara,
faith.
Bangeskia.
He said, without faith, it is impossible to
please him.
Please God. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. Two people, read verse 4.
Verse 4.
By faith.
Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than
Cain.
Two people came to worship God. They are the same parents. They came for the same reason. To worship God. To offer sacrifice. But if you are going to offer sacrifice to God, there is the correct way to do it. And there is the wrong way to do it. If you don't do it correctly, it will not be acceptable. And many of us today, we are serving God. We think we are serving Him. But many of us are not serving Him according to faith. What is this faith? Faith is a knowledge that comes from God. He said two people, Cain and Abel. He said Abel offered a more excellent sacrifice. Why was his own more excellent and acceptable? One, he brought an animal and slaughtered the animal and shed blood. Cain brought his own. He brought fruits. He brought fruits from his farm. His own was food he brought and beautified his altar. But Abel came and soiled his own with blood. And that is the one that was accepted. Why was his own accepted? Because they were coming for a sin offering. They are coming for a sin offering. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Bible tells us, without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Abel knew that revelation. That is the meaning of faith. Faith means revelation. Without faith, it is impossible to serve God. Apostle Paul told spoke about the Israelites. He said they have a zeal to serve God. They are zealous to serve God. But they are not serving him according to knowledge. And because they are not serving him according to knowledge, but very, very religious, God came, as it is written of him, they missed him. The God that they were serving
Allah na suna maza bauta
came standing before them.
Yazo ya saya garesu.
They missed him.
Suna sashi.
The Messiah they have been calling upon
Allah na suna kira suna
in expectation
suna marmari ngenishi
came as it is written of him.
Yazo ya daka rubuta kenishi.
It's in the books.
Anubuta alitatafeng.
But by the time he came,
amalo kuchina yazo,
the religious people at that time,
masu bauta adini,
they had left the Bible.
Sumbari litafi.
Left the Bible so far. Until if you show them something in the Bible, they cannot see it. Because they have gone too far from the Bible. And the only way for you to serve God acceptably is to come back to the Bible. And the same thing is happening today. The word of God came to us. God preserved his word in the Bible. But as soon as the apostles passed away, the same condition of Israel is the same condition the church is today. They have departed from the Bible. They are so far. They know more about denomination than they know about the Bible. They hold their denomination higher than the Bible. If you show them the Bible, they are too far to catch it. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I am saying this because I have heard a lot of things. They say one strange church has come to Akwanga. What is strange about us? Are we not holding Bible? Are we not preaching Bible? Is there anything we are saying contrary to this Bible? The problem is they have gone too far from the Bible. When you are showing them the Bible, they are too far to be able to see what is going on. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now Christianity has reduced to political party. People prefer to be identified with their church than to identify with Christ. You can make caricature Jesus Christ. They will not be angry.
When
you speak against their church, they are ready to kill you. Read 2 Corinthians chapter 13 verse 5. I will ask you that question. There is a question there. What does it say?
2 Corinthians 13:5.
Yes.
Examine yourselves.
Examine yourself.
Whether ye be in the faith.
Whether you are in the faith.
Prove your own self.
Prove it now.
Know ye not your own self? How that Jesus Christ is in you. Except ye be reprobates.
I have come to preach Jesus Christ. I have not come to preach church. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Christianity has been reduced to politics. Now people don't preach Christ. People preach church. When they go for evangelism, it's not to preach Christ. It's come to my church. Come to my church. Come to my church. Before they accept you, they want to find out, are you a member of a Christian Association of Nigeria? Ha! The reason why you are my brother is that you are a member of Christian Association of Nigeria. I am not a member of the Christian Association of Nigeria. I am a member of the family of Jesus Christ. We are a family. We are a family. We are a family. What joined me and you is a blood. It's not a constitution. It's not an association. It's the blood of Jesus Christ that flow from the cross on Calvary that bring me and you together. I can call you brother. I can call you sister. Not because I belong to an association. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It is the blood. I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood for me. Oh, one day when I was lost, Jesus died upon the cross. I know it was the blood for me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
People don't sing such songs again. People don't sing such songs again. Down at the cross, where my Savior died. Down where from cleansing from sin I cry. There through my heart was the blood of God. Oh, glory to His name. Glory to His name. Glory to His name. Oh yeah. Glory to His name. Glory to His name. Dead to my heart was the blood. Oh yes. Hallelujah. Glory to His name. At the cross.
At the cross. At the cross, where I fought so the last, and the bodies of my heart rolled away.
Hallelujah.
It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the way.
This world is not my hope,
I'm just a passing through. My treasures are laid down somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't be at home.
Yes,
this world, the whole of the
world.
Oh, Lord,
I have no friend like you.
I have no friend like you. If heaven is not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me.
Yes, sir.
From heaven's open door, and I can't be at home. It's not anymore.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
On earth here, I'm an ego man.
Adunia Allah nashi mutimi egoni.
But that the truth is, I'm a heavenly candidate.
Amashi dea de gachia ya mulki Allah ne.
My home is not here.
Bajenshi ba adunia eki.
My home is far beyond the sky.
Kidanshi ina na.
My home is in heaven.
Kidanshi ina sam.
How many people have that home in heaven?
Mutunazuna de.
Oh, glory be to God. There is a country far beyond the starry sky. There's a city where there never comes a night. If we are faithful, we shall go there by and by.
It's a city.
Oh,
is the city where the Lamb is the light.
Hallelujah.
Is the city where the Lamb is the light. The city where the common man I have a mansion over there. I love him from time to time.
We are traveling
on the right road.
Oh,
we are traveling on the right road. There is one way to the city of God.
Oh,
we are traveling
on the right road. If you will go, if you will go,
if you will not go,
hinder me, don't hinder me. Hallelujah.
If you won't go,
don't hinder me,
don't hinder me.
If you won't go,
if you won't go,
don't hinder me,
don't hinder me.
No,
I'm on my way,
praise the Lord to the glory. Oh, I'm on my way,
I'm on my way,
I'm on my way
to the glory.
I'm on my way. I will see Jesus
someday, sometimes.
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 I will see Jesus. See Jesus
someday,
sometimes.
I will see Jesus someday.
That's our hope. God bless you. Be seated. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So please, if you think that I have come to carry the members of your political church,
hold
your peace. I am your brother. I have not come with anything new. I have come to join you to shine the light. I have come to lift up the name of our Savior. That's all we came here for. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There's nothing we are struggling for. Nothing we are struggling for. If you have your ministry, oh, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. If you have a ministry, hallelujah. Listen, God cannot use only you. According to Ephesians chapter 4, he said, every joint supply. Everyone has something to supply. I have come to add to the one you have been doing in
Akwanga.
I have not come to kill your own. I have not come to destroy your own. I have come to add more fire. I have come to shine more light. So don't be afraid. Unless it is not God you are serving. If it is something else you are doing there, I have come to deliver the children of God. There are places that are occultic, but they hide under Bible. Any such place in Akwanga here, that cage will break to pieces. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Any church that a witch is the reverend, let them hear, thus said the Lord. Let my people go. Hallelujah.
Amen.
A living church, a sinner cannot be comfortable there. A living church. A witch cannot be comfortable there. A living church. When sin has come, they will repent. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Listen, church. I don't believe in branches. I don't believe in branches. If I was to join the people to open branches, my church would be the fastest growing all over the world. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I have people following my ministry. Millions of them all around the world.
Million adunia duka.
In almost every country you can think of. Thanks to the internet. Thanks to the satellite. Thanks to the social network. Media. People are following us. What are they following? It's not me they are following. They are hearing something. They are hearing something that is bringing them back to Christ. Their relationship with God is becoming better. I am not bringing people to follow me. I am bringing people to come back to Jesus Christ. Men have hijacked the church of Jesus Christ. And they have taken the seat of the Holy Ghost. And they
said
they are general overseer. And they said they are reverend. And they have said they are apostles. And they have said they are all manner of names. And they draw people to themselves. Instead of drawing people to their master, they have hijacked the church of Jesus Christ. And people worship men and think that they are worshiping God. And people are serving their church and serving God. But I've come to tell you, hey, come back to Jesus Christ. Come back to Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Don't be angry with me. I am at home here. And I come to Akwanga, I'm at home. This is my place of birth. Here I belong. So I will speak, I will talk. I want God to deliver my people. And you people know my history. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I've been in the military since 1973. I was an Air Force officer. And you know my family are both Christians and Muslims. You know, a lot of you know the Aluegbe family. And you know my background. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I had no time for God. I was as worldly as anything. A little thing happened. Just a little thing happened in my office. And they kept me in detention for 2 years. In a Koyi prison. But while I was there condemned by man, Christ came to me. I met Christ in the prison here. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In 1989, I met Christ. And God kept me there so that I will study and know him. I thank God for going inside the prison
here.
Inside there, I began to study to know him.
And
that's why my Christianity is not religion. My Christianity is not religion. My Christianity is relationship with God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And of course, there were questions to be asked. When I gave my life to Christ, all of us are holding one Bible. Then why are we divided? That question was disturbing me. Another question. I saw people that were having gifts. anointing. Very, very anointed. But living dirty life. Pastor that is anointed.
Pastor
and yet fornicating. And anointing was flowing. I
said,
what is this mystery? I was disturbed. I will soon leave prison yard. Every day I expected to be released. I pray to God, which church will I go when I come out? Not to waste your time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God answered my question.
Allah ya answer tambayansa.
When I met the minister of William Branham.
And
that is where I receive all the answers. I knew that you can have the anointing. And you may not be converted. It's a mystery. It's in the Bible. I know you can speak in tongues and still live a useless life. I knew that there's a difference between the baptism of the Holy Ghost and the anointing of the Holy Ghost. I understood that mystery. Why he said, not everyone that say, Lord, 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 will enter the kingdom. He said, some will come in that day. Was it not your name? I cast out devils. I did mighty miracles, signs and wonders. He said, I didn't know you. So I got to know that you may be anointed and casting out devils, doing mighty miracles, signs and wonders in the name of Jesus, and Jesus may not know you. It's a mystery. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I got to know where the church was divided. And then we discover that a time in the history of the church, something happened. Paganism and Christianity married together. Married together into association. They married together for whatever reason. Church, there is church history. What the church did when the church started, there was no equa. There was no Baptist. There was no ERCC. Talk about cooking. When the church started, there was no Catholic. When the church started, there was no bride. No bride.
Bride.
No bride. No
bride.
Bride.
Assembly.
Bride assembly. Not the.
Bride. Bride assembly.
And when the church started, there was no archbishop.
Archbishop.
And when the church started, there was no reverend father.
Bride. Reverend father.
And when the church started,
Bride.
There was no altar with special seat for Gio. In fact, when the church started, there was no general overseer. When the church started, there was no woman pastor. When the church started, any fornicator that enter church, Holy Ghost will strike him. He will die there. When the church started, sinners were afraid to come to church. When the church started, they were not preaching prosperity. When the church started, the testimony of a minister was not the number of cars he has, the designer shoe he has, the air conditioned auditorium he built. When the church started, there was no Bible school. Am I saying something? Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when did all this come into the church? It was when the world married the church.
They
join together. The world has entered the church. The church now has become worldly. They kept Christ away. Until we come to Revelation chapter
3.
Christ was pushed out of the church. He was standing outside, knocking. I want to come to my church. I want to take over. They have taken over my church. Men have taken over my church. They will not allow me to rule my church again. They have divided my church among themselves. I want to come in. And he said, whosoever open, I open my own. I open. He said he will come in. And when he comes in, he will take preeminence. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
A simple doctrine. Simple, the simplest doctrine in the Bible. They cannot see it there. Ordinary water baptism. They say we are preaching error. Listen. Galatians chapter 1. Read it for me. Verse 6, 7, and 8. Galatians chapter 1. Verse 6, 7, and 8.
Galatians chapter 1, verse 6, 7, and 8. I marvel that you are so soon removed from him that called you into the grace of Christ unto another gospel, which is not another. But there be some that trouble you
and will
pervert the gospel of Christ. But though we or an angel from heaven preach any other gospel unto you than that which have been preached unto you, let him be accursed.
Let that person what?
Be accursed.
The next verse.
As we said before.
As I've said before.
So say I now again.
If
any man preach any other gospel unto you.
Any man
than that you have received. Let him be accursed.
Listen. That scripture will stand to judge every one of us preaching on the day of judgment. Any other gospel you preach contrary to this Bible. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He said you are accursed. With this scripture alone, it's easy for you to know a cost minister standing at the pulpit. Listen, church. I say I am a preacher of the cross of Calvary. I say all these things for somebody to understand who we are. They have been fighting us. In Lagos, they have fought me.
Lagos, my father,
anywhere they have fought me. But it is the same thing that happened to the apostles. They have gone too far to understand what we are saying. They are feeling too proud to descend and correct. But God will always leave himself a witness. Gross darkness cover everywhere. But the Bible says at evening time, there shall be light. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is that light.
We
are taking all over the world. And we thank God that nothing can hinder God. Through the internet, the satellites, including Saudi Arabia, even Muslims, Hindus,
Buddhists,
they are hearing us and they are getting converted. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I'm aware that religion is sensitive here. So I'll be careful to speak against Islam. Because that is not my concern with them. My ministry is for those my brethren that are serving God but in error. You are serving God very sincere, but very sincerely wrong. They are the ones I am concerned about. The message is come out of those errors and come and have a relationship with God through the scriptures. That is my ministry. And thousands of people have believed me. You watch my television channel. You can see the number of people that are gathered there in Lagos. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And one thing with my people up north here. Especially in this part, Akwanga. It will surprise you that not even members of my family that are Christians come to my church. But if it was a political party I formed, they would have all joined me. That's why I told you, a prophet is without honor only in his hometown. And so I was not interested in coming. I have my blood relations that are living in Lagos, but they cannot come to me because they want to go to churches that will allow them to wear a ring and paint their faces and look like prostitutes. They want to go to churches that will allow women to wear trousers and the pastor will say it doesn't matter.
You see,
a man. Amen.
Amen.
So they see me as strange. Very, very strange. So I said my people will not receive it. That's why I remained there. I remain in
Lagos.
When I come home, they are looking at me as one strange man. They say he believe one kind message. I heard one time that some of my cousins, they gathered and they were fasting and praying for me. They say, hey, our brother, we are happy that he got born again. But he's holding to strange doctrine. So I told her, I say, pray very well. Pray very well. So that God will deliver me. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And it was when the television program started.
And
then people will phone. When I ask, where are you from? They say they are Kwanga. And they even speak Igon. When I tell them Igon, they will say, no, no lie. So when so many calls were coming from Nasarawa State, Akwanga, usually, every December, I come home. We come home and we meet our family together, family reunion. So 3 years back, I think, three or four years back, so I just said, since I will be home, okay, let me announce, I will come and bless you people.
Who
and to my greatest surprise, they all came and gathered. I saw people were many. They were many. That is why I say it means they will receive me. And so I decided, if it is so, since this is my home, let me have a church here. So that if they drive me come out from
Lagos,
I go run, come here, continue. Come home, nobody will drive me. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And the devil has been fighting Akwanga church. Both internally and externally. And many people that ran to Akwanga church, some of them came in continuation of their denominational setting. This is my brother church. This is my brother church. This is my our church. I carry my hand put for head. Oh, these people, this spirit will not leave this people. Who is my brother? Is it because you speak my language? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And God knows how to announce us. I forgot to tell you something. I was in Lagos. Nobody from my family will come near me. All of them, including my own last born. Is there somewhere here? Maggie?
Have one can change in my
Grace, where are you?
Grace,
you
know, put her
one. See them, Grace. See them. They're all my blood sisters.
They
will not condemn me. So God did something. One of my cousins was suffering from HIV.
HIV.
He blew to AIDS.
AIDS.
Some and then she was in isolation ward in Jude. You know who I'm talking about? Grace.
Grace,
you know, I'm not going to call her name. And then she was waiting to die. Hair has gone off. Everything was gone. She was just a ghost. And then somebody went to her in the hospital. Your brother, God is using him in Lagos. You stay here, you are dying. I stayed, they phoned me. I say, who be that? I say, you are in Jos now. That's your problem. If you call here, I'll go pray for you. I don't give pray for her for phone. That church where no one call you must come.
Please, let me give you 20 dollars. Second, she's a cafe.
Then pack and pull for moto.
I'm quite sure to answer a moto.
I just tell her this. I see somebody.
You know,
they were holding her. She came with her daughter.
That's what
she hold a Milo Gongoni. Where she was spitting and putting coffee every minute. I left her. I said, oh God. Use her healing. So that my family will know I am your servant. I come back to him. To her. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That nonsense left her.
HIV
disappeared. When she came home, they saw her. What is this? From there, when I travel, come home, they will come and grow my house.
Please pray for us.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He came to his own. His own received him not. But how many of you receive us here? I say, there will be no more bondage. I say there will be no more bondage. In the name of Jesus Christ. I said, now that they have received me, every year a person must die in my family. One, two people, they will die. I said, Lord, now that they have received me, let nobody die again. Let nobody die again. I wrote the names of all my family members that I remember. I came to the altar where this pulpit is.
In the bagadi,
I put it there and left it there permanent. I
said,
I bring every member of my family under the mercy of God. And so when one day my elder sister Hajia, according to her testimony, she was sick unto death. She knew she was going to die. She said suddenly she found herself somewhere, and white people dressed in white surrounded her and held their hands, and she saw me come in the middle dressed in white and prayed for her. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When she walked out of that revelation, she became healed. From there, she go carry Bright TV.
It's
in her bedroom. When we are blessing water, she's blessing her water. God will do something that everybody around you will notice you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I am trying to tell you that may God do something that will make you believe what we have brought to you here in Akwanga. There must be light that will shine in Akwanga. I said there must be light that will shine in this
Akwanga.
Darkness will disappear. Witches and wizards will give way. I said they will repent, or they will repent. In the name of Jesus Christ.